All right, guys, more put image stuff. I was hacking around today and I came up with another transparent put image routine. This is in Turbo Pascal. In a previous video, I showed you how to do transparent put image using a mask. This time, I'm going to show you how to do it without a mask, but only in mode 13. So we have an image here. 58 by 51 pixels, and it's a 256 color image. And I'm going to show you how it looks. And what you'll notice, the black image is our background there. That's not what we want. I wrote this little routine here. I'll go through it. But before I do that, I'm using the Jordan Hard Graphics SVGA 256 driver. Now, I'm not using an SVGA mode. I'm only using the 320 by 200 by 256 mode, and that's because Turbo Pascal doesn't support this with the built-in drivers. They support higher resolutions, but not at the 256 color mode. So that's the only way I can get this, or I could use some additional programming, but I want to stick with the Borland graphics interface. That's the BGI. But I'm also going to access the screen memory directly. When I was younger, I didn't think this was possible. I thought there was some kind of rule that if you were using the BGI that you couldn't mix direct memory access, but it looks like it works just fine. So here is my routine here that I mapped the video memory. Now, this looks a little different than what you might see on other sites on the internet. Normally you would see a single array. I'm using a multi-dimensional array, and I'm mapping it in reverse, basically 0 to 199, which is the height, and 0 to 319, which is the width. If you do it in the opposite order, things don't map properly to the video memory. But doing it this way allows us to access each pixel directly. We just specify the location, but in reverse. The Y coordinate goes first and the X coordinate goes afterwards. And this is what this line does. And I have a replacement put image, which does the same thing as the built-in one, with the exception that we specify which color we want to be transparent. So we have this variable here, and we pass the color that we want to be transparent. Now we also pass the image, and the internal structure of the image is the first integer or word is the width, the second is the height, minus one basically. So if the width is 10, it would store 9. If the height was 10, it would store 9. And then the following data is the actual image. So what I do to map that is I create a record here with that structure, and I create a pointer that points to that structure. And right here, I assign the memory of the image we're passing to that structure variable. So this allows us to access that information. So the image will change all the time, but by doing this, we can access the height here, we can access the width, and the IM array is accessing the image. Now you'll notice I'm doing like 0 to 0, which seems kind of silly. I don't know what the size of what the image will be. So whatever number I put here really doesn't matter. I can put the full length of of what I'm allowed to put here, but it doesn't matter. As long as we're only reading that value, we're not going to corrupt anything. And that's the only thing I'm doing. I'm only reading that value. I'm not setting anything. I am setting the screen memory, which is right here. This is where we do our little calculation to where to plot the image. And every time we plot a pixel, we increment the image memory counter. So we start off at zero. So we're accessing this right here, this IM variable, which is storing the image. We start off at zero, next value will be one, following until it reaches the end. And we know we'll reach the end because we're doing a double for loop that cycles through the width and the height. So once that finishes, we don't even need to keep track of this. We just keep incrementing by one, and we always have the right pixel. So that's the explanation. Now let's do the demonstration. So first, I'm gonna uncomment this so you can see. So the image on the left is using the built-in put image. The image on the right is my put image routine, which accepts a color for that you want it to be transparent or not drawn at all. So let me just put some color bars on the screen so you can actually get a better idea of how it is. And so that's it. I know it doesn't, it's not that impressive, but this is one of those things I've been wanting to do for a long time. And so that's off my bucket list. I hope you find some use for this. And that's it for this video.